Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Crystal, and in today's video, I want to talk about the differences between hormonal IUDs and copper IUDs. IUDs are a really interesting type of birth control because there are non-hormonal IUDs and there are hormonal IUDs, so why not talk about them? Now you might be wondering, like, what the heck is an IUD? So an IUD is a plastic T-shaped device that has a little string attached to it that sits in your uterus. Now an IUD can either release hormones or it can be wrapped in copper. Now IUDs are inserted into the uterus and they also have a string that will be in the cervix, and the string is meant to be there for removal purposes, but it's also meant to be there so you can check to make sure that the IUD is like still in place. Now the reason why someone would want an IUD is because they are very effective methods of birth control. And so that is what IUDs are used for. They're used for birth control purposes. And copper IUDs can actually be used as emergency contraceptive if they are inserted within 5 days of unprotected sex. IUDs have a lot of pros, they also have some cons, and so I think it's really important to talk about the pros, the cons, and all the in-between. So the first kind of IUD is a hormonal-based IUD. So hormonal IUDs are IUDs that will release progesterone into your body. And so hormonal IUDs go by different names. So there's the Mirena, the Kylena, and the Jadess. Each of those secrete a different amount of progesterone into your uterus daily. And so that is why if you're interested in IUD, especially hormonal IUD, you want to make sure that you're getting the IUD that is going to be right for you, because they are also different sizes, and so that's another important reason why to talk to someone, because you might be really interested in one but might not be the right size for you. Hormonal IUDs last about 3 to 5 years, and they are incredibly effective forms of birth control. There was a recent study that showed that they're actually just a little bit more effective than the copper IUD at preventing pregnancy. They do have a little bit of a cost associated with them, and so they range from about $290 and up, and that is Canadian, so I'm not really sure what that means in your currency, but I looked up online to see how much it costs in Canadian, and the cheapest one was about $290 Canadian. Now, because they do release progestin into your uterus, they can stop ovulation. Now, this doesn't happen for everyone, but for a lot of people that do have hormonal IUDs, they will not ovulate, or at least not ovulate every cycle. When you do take the IUD out, because you are having hormones in your system, you might not restore your fertility as quickly as if you had like a copper IUD. But the main reason why hormonal IUDs are great is not only that they're effective, but they're also really great at reducing menstrual flow and sometimes even stopping periods altogether. They also really help reduce menstrual cramps, and they can be really beneficial for people who have things like endometriosis. Now, the way that the hormonal IUD works is it does release progesterone into your system, which thickens your cervical fluid, but it also makes your uterine lining really thin. It also damages and kills sperm as well. Now, there are some risks associated with hormonal IUDs. You know, they do stop ovulation, so when you do take them out, your fertility might not come back as quickly as maybe you were expecting. They can also cause you to have irregular bleeding for the first few months after insertion. They can also cause you to have some side effects from the birth control. So progestin birth control does have some side effects, and so you could experience those side effects because you are having progestin released into your system. And so those are just some things to be aware of. The other big thing is that they can expel, and so they might last for 3 to 5 years, but they can expel unexpectedly. You never know. Another risk is that when you do have it inserted, you always have the risk of having your uterus perforated. There is that risk there. And so the other thing to be really mindful of is that there has been a recent study that has come out that shows that if you use a menstrual cup, that menstrual cups can actually dislodge IUDs. Doesn't really matter if it's a copper or hormonal IUD, but they can dislodge it because menstrual cups use suction, and so that could potentially lead to your IUD being expelled or like displaced. And so I just think that's really important because I know a lot of people love using menstrual cups, and it might not be the best thing to use when you have an IUD. So let's move on to the second type of IUD, and that is the non-hormonal IUD, which is the copper IUD. So the copper IUD, depending on what kind you get, can last for 5 to 10 years. It's 99% effective and it can be used as emergency contraception, like I said earlier in the video. The other thing to note with the copper IUD is that it's a lot cheaper than the hormonal IUDs. So the cost that I was able to find online was about $90-ish Canadian. Kind of depended on like where you went and what kind of copper IUD, but that was kind of like the ballpark. But it's a lot more affordable. Now, the thing with the copper IUD is because it is non-hormonal, it does not stop ovulation. So when you have a copper IUD, you will still be ovulating and having like a regular cycle. Now, the way that a copper IUD works is that copper is actually toxic to sperm. So that's how it prevents pregnancy, is that sperm basically just gets damaged and killed when it enters your uterus. The other thing is that the copper IUD can like irritate the uterine lining, which makes it hard for the egg to implant. Now, the copper IUD can increase bleeding and it can increase cramping. And so if you have painful periods or if you have like a heavy flow, a copper IUD is not going to be for you. Because you do have a regular cycle and you are still ovulating, you are still going to get periods. And the main kind of complaint with copper IUDs is that they can make periods a little bit more painful and a lot more heavier. A copper IUD can also cause you to spot between cycles, and it can also change your cervical fluid discharge. So those are kind of important to be aware of. And of course, like the hormonal IUD, it can dislodge, it can displace. There's also the risk of perforating your uterus when you get it inserted. And of course, if you do use a menstrual cup, it can also possibly dislodge or displace your copper IUD. The other thing to note with copper IUDs is that there is some like anecdotal evidence that copper IUDs might possibly displace zinc in your body. Copper and zinc have to be in like a pretty fine balance in your body. That's just how it is. And copper IUDs might possibly displace zinc. And so you might become like deficient in zinc or have like a low zinc status. And so if you do have a copper IUD, it's always good to make sure like to get your copper and zinc levels tested and to just be aware of that. We should just be aware of these things, right? Like, it's just so important. Now, when it comes to getting an IUD inserted, usually you do it at a doctor's office or like a health clinic. Sometimes they use local anesthetic, sometimes not. I don't have personal experience getting an IUD, but I have heard from a lot of people that it can be quite painful when you get it inserted. Some people don't mind it, some people say it's awful. So just like prepare yourself. It's probably not gonna be like a super quick walk in the park, but when you do go to your doctor's office or your health clinic to get an IUD, they will walk you all through this. But I just wanted you to be like aware that it might be quite uncomfortable to have it inserted as well as removed. So I hope you guys learned something in this video. If you have any questions, please let me know. But if you do have any questions that are like really specific to types of IUDs or like what the best IUD is for you or that kind of thing, talk to your healthcare provider. That is who you want to talk to about that kind of stuff. I'm just here to educate you. I'm not here to tell you what to do or decide which one is best for you. It's definitely something you have to talk to with your provider. So as always, your cycle matters so much, and I'm here for you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!